Hello and good evening, everyone. The Missouri Tigers will try for their first 3-0 start this weekend since 2003, and they'll do so against the Lobos of New Mexico. In their first visit to Albuquerque, the Tiger defense will try to prevent the offensive onslaught they suffered last year against the Lobos. The Tigers lost that game 45-35. The Mizzou defense has allowed a mere 156 yards of offense per game this season on average. Their job should be easier with New Mexico's starting quarterback Cole McCamey on the sidelines for the season. Last year was a tough loss for the Tigers, but they are excited for a chance at a little revenge.
We have a little saying now that we're not going to New Mexico to play. We get to go to New Mexico and play, and that's a good way to look at it.
One reason why we have not done as well and played consistent enough is we don't play our A game enough. We don't play consistent enough. So it's not real complex why we haven't played well. And like I've said before, if when you play your A game, it doesn't mean you're going to win, but it certainly gives you opportunities to win. And that's our focus.
This week's high school football rankings for Missouri are in. Mid-Missouri claimed 8 spots in the rankings this week. The 2-0 Rockbridge Bruins are still on top of Class 6A after their victory down in Arkansas last Friday. The Lakers of Camden Tinner in the number 5 spot in 5A, and the Webb City Cardinals are on top of the 4A division. 2A has Blair Oaks at number 1, Brookfield in 3rd, and Centralia in 4th place, and South Shelby and Salisbury take the number 2 and number 10 spots respectively in Class 1A. The Jeff City Boys soccer team traveled to Columbia tonight to take on rival Hickman. The Jays are off to a rough start at 1-3. The Cupes are on the other side of the glass at 3 wins, 1 loss, and 1 tie. Out at Hickman Field, a bit of a cold night. Is it too early for hot chocolate? Not out at Hickman. First half, scoreless game. Hickman's John Corbin almost gets the goal. Not quite enough as the Jeff City gets the nice stop. 3 minutes to go in the first half. Evan Camden scores on the header, puts the Cupes up 1-0. Now to the second half. Camden takes the pass from David Garman, goes off of the Jeff City keeper and in. Hickman would go on to win by the score of 2-0 over the Jeff City Jays. The St. Louis Cardinals took on division rival Houston Astros at Busch Stadium tonight. The Redbirds are well ahead of the Stros with a 6-game advantage, but Houston has their eye on a possible wild card berth for the playoffs. Bottom of the third now, 1-1. Preston Wilson, his 15th home run of the season, 6th with the Cardinals since leaving the Houston Astros earlier about a month ago. Andy Pettit would leave after this inning with a strained elbow, but the Cardinals are up 2-1. Top of the fourth now, same score, bases loaded. Orlando Palmeiro with the 2-run RBI double scores Luke Scott and Chris Burke. Houston would go up 3-2, a bit of a tug of war in this game. Bottom of the fifth now, runners on first and second. Dave Burkowski strikes out Scott Rowland. Scott Rowland not happy with that call, argues with the umpire, and believe it or not, Scott Rowland, one of the calmest players in the game, gets thrown out. Not happy about that call. Top of the sixth now, 1-1. Chris Burke puts himself on the board with a 2-run homer, his 9th of the year. Astros go up 5-4. That would be the score going into the bottom of the ninth when Albert Pujols, going against his nemesis Brad Lich, he doubles. Skip Schumacher and Scott Spezio come around to score. Pujols with the walk-off double. Cardinals go on to win by the score of 6-5. The Kansas City Royals and the Cleveland Indians are at the bottom of the AL Central Division barrel. They met in Cleveland tonight, each team trying not to be the one ending up with the title of Tough Luck Team in the Central Division. Tonight at Jacobs Field, Jeremy Sowers pitching for the Indians. Top of the first, 1-1 for John Buck. RBI single brings around Mark Grudzielanek. That makes it 2-0, Kansas City. Bottom of the third now is run out. Third, Ronaldis Hernandez strikes out Ryan Garko to end the inning. Now here's something you don't usually see. Hernandez not too happy with his catcher. He starts fighting with his own team. Cleared the bench, but only on one side of the game. Bottom of the fourth now, Andy Marte pops up. Mark Grudzielanek, what a stellar defensive play by him. Diving catch. Bottom of the ninth now, 1-1. Joe Nelson gets Jason Michaels to fly out to end the game. Kansas City goes on to win 5-3. Doesn't matter a whole lot because they're still at the bottom of the division.